on. You quit for getting after it. Everybody was sweaty. You were breathing hard. I see everybody's getting a lot better today, which I thank you for. Remember our goal every day when we come in, we want to get at least 1% better. Because you don't stay the same. You either get better or you get worse. I've seen everybody in this room get better today. Practice is for trying out moves. A lot of the skills we did today were new to everybody. That cartwheel, none of us have ever hit before, or even taught it before. Some of this stuff, Greco, is very different. You kids, now it's going to be fun to what to see if you come to this. Because now you kids are on more of a European system. In Europe, they wrestle year-round. They don't compete a lot. That's what we're doing now. We're wrestling year-round. We're not competing a lot. And we're going to see how it pays off when these kids transition from folk style and wrestle a couple months of freestyle and Greco. So you guys are going to be used to these positions. Once we all meet up in the spring, it's going to be interesting to see how this plays out. And they just released the U.S. schedule, too. So the U.S. Open is coming. I'd like to see Jarvis wrestling in that. Coach Briggs. So we got our senior level guys that are going to be able to compete.
When is that?
And we'll talk about that after practice. But the dates are coming the next few months. Even for some of you high school kids, they got cadets and juniors. That would be a way for you to try to represent the United States and get on some of these teams. You'll be a little more in-depth and trained than these kids that are just doing Greco for that little short span of those couple months. Yeah, so just try to reframe something that happens that might be bad. And Damian's got a good mix because he's doing folk style Greco, so he's going to be, you know, his own unique case. So just try to use your situation you got and try to make the best out of it that we can. And I was talking to a coach the other day, and he was telling me how his house burned down and the state finals was in the next day. So he had to coach his team, and he was about 15 miles away. He said he heard his wife called him and said, hey, the house is burning down. She thought maybe it was just burning like a hot dog or something. 15 miles, he looked in the air, and he seen the smoke was already coming. It's out of the country. It's back in Illinois. So he had to go home. His house was burned to the ground. Now, let's see, this is not happening to you kids, but adversity is going to hit. And the moral of the story is when adversity hit, I was like, what did you do? How did you get yourself mentally ready to go win a team state title that next day when you have your family, like everything to worry about? And he said he started with doing one thing right. So his house was burned down. He needed to find a place for his family to sleep. They went to his mother's house. Luckily, she wasn't too far. And then he found a toothbrush and a bar of soap for everybody in the family. And that got them through the night. He focused on wrestling the next day, and they started to build. So wherever you're at in life, just try to do that next thing right and start building out there. It doesn't matter what happened yesterday or before. Take it from today. You've all put these 2 hours in. You've done amazing. Just keep building on that. Find the next thing to do right if something bad happens. Because especially with 2020, we all know bad stuff has happened a lot. Just try to do the next thing right and start climbing these goals on top of each other. And that's how we're going to get better. Everybody understand that makes sense?
Yes, sir.
Thanks to you. Coaches, you guys got anything for them? Yeah.